Lovely cup of tea. Hope you can hear me all right, folks. I'm just doing a little test here at the moment. Legend 27, hello, bud. I've not streamed this channel before. I've literally just turned it on. I wanted to see whether or not anyone would come in. So there's only one person here at the moment. Is me mic all right? Still a bit croaky. Sorry about that. That's probably a bit loud then, wouldn't it? Let's get that mic in a bit nearer. I don't know if you can just see that on the edge there. Hey, how about like that? Maybe. I'll just sit here for a bit just to get a, see, hopefully, a few of my subscribers in. This is my, obviously, my Butler's Empire channel. So we'll have a look. Anything I can show you? I think you've seen that. That's my new stickers, which are coming out in about 12 stickers time after I've got rid of these ones on my Retro Restore channel. anything else I can show you? Not at the moment. So it's a bit quiet in here. There's just over 1,000 subscribers on this channel, but as I say, I'm hoping maybe after Christmas in the new year to move over my Retro Restore live streams onto this channel, but if no one's watching it, I won't do it. I'm hoping the let's just check that. Is it live chat up there? Pop out chat. There's different settings on here. I don't normally use the YouTube software. All right, Pete. Okay, mate. I'm just checking out this new well, not checking out. I'm just looking at the streaming on Butler's Empire channel. I haven't done this. I'm using the YouTube Studio software at the moment, and it's not what I normally use. So this is sort of all new to me. There's not a lot I can do on here, to be honest with you, apart from just talk to people. As you know, other people use streaming software like I do. I use OBS normally, and other people use that StreamYard settings software rather when they get people come up and talk to them. But this is just YouTube. I don't think YouTube's got that facility. I've not had a look around of it yet, but all I can see is pop out chat, whatever that means, and toggle time. Jason, fourth one today, mate. I'll see you on Chris's stream this morning. I'm still a bit chesty, actually, and it's pouring rain out there, and I'm not going. I'm just testing this out, Jason. I wanted to see if anyone was getting the notification come up on Butler's Empire channel, because as you know, I want to hopefully in the new year start streaming on there if enough people can come over. So I don't see that at the moment. All I can see is like the three people that are in the chat room at the moment. And I don't know. Oh, it's seven. Is there seven people? Yeah, there's only seven people watching apparently. So there is other people there. If anybody else is there, and just put your name down on the live chat if you can, if you're available, just let me know that you are there. I'm not getting much work done today, Jason says. Oh, Jason, I've done absolutely nothing apart from sit here. I've looked at a few videos on the 3D printer that I've just bought, but I was going to put it together yesterday. It arrived yesterday, but no, not the way yesterday went. Everything was going wrong, as you know. And Jimmy's just been outside. His van didn't start, as you know. Gary's had to come down and give him a jump start, so that's that. Alleyway, how are you, bud? Jason Peacock, how are you, matey? Just doing a little test stream at the moment. It's terrible weather out there. I don't know where you are in the UK or wherever you are in the world, but how's Jimmy's ankle? Yeah, it's a lot better now. He had 2 days rest with it, and on the second day, he laid in bed with it, elevated his foot, and the swelling went down, and it started to bruise, so that's always a sign that it was improving. Now he's walking on it, so he's back at work at the moment. How's the Signum? Pete, I haven't done no work on the Signum since the last time you've seen it on the video. That's before I was away in Cyprus. I keep meaning to get on it to get outside, but as you know, when we come back off of Cyprus, the weather's been absolutely lousy, and as a result of that, I didn't fancy sitting on the floor or laying down under a wet car and doing that. So I've stuck to sort of internal stuff. As you can see, I've done that little coach on my Retro Hacks channel. What else have I done? I'd done the worst lawnmower repair yesterday. And again, I left a comment. Someone left a comment on there. Oh, that's no good, that video. Well, you're scraping the bottom of the barrel with that one, doing that again. No, that shows you that if you buy pattern parts and you leave them for a couple of years, sometimes they don't hold up. I've had lawnmowers out there, as you probably know, for years and years. Put a drop of fresh petrol in them and they'll start, providing they got spark. But that one I knew had pattern diaphragm and gaskets on it, and the pattern primer bulb, both of them had failed, and I hadn't used the mower, so it was just sitting outside in the rough. So that's it. Let's just have a quick look. A few more of you have popped in now. We've got 14 in there. Hiya, Mark. I did see you on Chris's chat this morning, and Jason, obviously. Alleyway, Pete, who else we got there? Tom Crabtree. Hiya, bud. Jason Peacock. Yo, you're in Belfast, and it's not a good day. Yeah, raining. I think it's like that all over the UK, isn't it? Barstow to Vegas. Good afternoon. Is it afternoon? Just. I didn't realise that. I've been sitting here all morning on YouTube drinking tea. So, are you, Simon? But I'm still not right. That's why I don't really want to go out in the rain. And also, well, I've got to finish a restoration on my Retro Hacks channel. I don't know if I showed you that. What was that little burner called? It was like a little camp stove, solid cast iron base. And that's the thing I'm restoring at the moment. But I can't show you anything on it because this isn't the normal software I use. So this is just streaming off of YouTube at the moment. I wanted to see if anyone would come in. So we've got 15 people in here at the moment. So that's not too bad. Chris French. How are you, Chris? All right, matey. Simon Scott. I said hello to Simon, didn't I? Yeah. So as I say, this software to me at the moment is all new to me. And I can't program anything into it so that you can see, or I can show you stuff on the screen. So that's that. That's all I can do at the moment. So I've been working on the calendar. Me and Sharon have got our photos to do on that, on our calendar, as you probably know. I can't show you any of the pictures yet, but all I can show you is a little test of the size of the calendar. This isn't the actual calendar, but that's the actual size of the calendar. It's an A4 calendar. I've done a couple of test prints sort of thing, you know, so that's what the calendar is going to look like. You'll have your month there, obviously 12 pages. And I've just done that's only for me and Sharon, just a little test one. But that's the format of the calendar anyway. So that's what we're going to be obviously selling off on the super chats on our. But the pictures, let's just say they're comedic pictures. Let's put it that way. Me and Sharon, we had Chris round yesterday, Sharon's brother, who's also appearing in the calendar. Sharon, what's he, United Kingdom talk, and let's just say he dressed up a little bit. That's all I'll say. Are your fun things to do with tech? Just a little test on this channel, Granddad's Workshop. Hiya, bud. Yeah, it's too wet out there, and as I say, I was in the log cabin yesterday restoring that fire, that little camping stove thing which I told you about. I had to stop. What did I have to stop for? What was I doing? Oh, I can't remember. I forget day to day. One day drifts into the next. It's now, is it Thursday today, Gary? Thursday? Is it Wednesday? Thursday, isn't it? Yeah. Well, I've got to have that restoration done for tomorrow. So I've got to get out there again in a minute. But my fire's packed up. My gas fire has packed up in there. So I've got another thing I've got to fix. And everything's in a mess in there. And oh, God. So let's have a little look here in the comment section. I say this is only a test stream, this one, anyway. Alan, are you Alan? Morning or afternoon? Just into the afternoon now. Stream is coming through to you okay. Yeah. But another reason why I wanted to do this test stream, because I went on Mick Mower's little test stream from his log cabin or his new shed at the bottom of his garden yesterday. And I went on his stream. I've been on his stream before. And I was all fuzzy and broken up. So I thought there was a possible problem there. And I done a broadband speed check. Apparently I was getting 27, which should be enough megabytes per second. Is it download or upload? I can't remember. But anyway, I should have a guaranteed 35. So I phoned up BT. They said there looks like there is an issue and they think it's within my house. So we'll have to see. They're coming down next Tuesday to have a look. But I just wanted to see, is this clear, this stream, as per it should be, as they normally are? Matthew Stapleton, how are you, buddy? I'm not too bad at the moment. Well, I'll say I've got a bit chesty at the moment. Fun things to do. Says it's very wet in Cornwall, and you only get two. Yeah, I heard you say that yesterday. About 2 megabytes, yeah. Normally, you want about 4 or 5 to stream decently, didn't you? Doug says we're coming through loud and clear. Yeah, Gary's over the back there. You can't see him. He's just out of shot. So he's just give Jimmy a jump start on his car, his van, rather. So, and that, again, I put a brand new battery on that van not so long back. He must have a problem with something draining out, because when he leaves the van for 3 or 4 days, flat battery. So I don't think it's the alternator, because the alternator charging light's not coming on. Although you can never tell, can you? So that's something else to look at. But Ian Days, are you Ian? You get about, Ian. I see you on quite a lot of streams. Well, all of you, actually. Mark Bowles, Jason's everywhere. Even Fun Things to Do with Tech, he's on many different streams. Oh, pardon me. So, yeah, after I've had this cup of tea and maybe had a little chat with you boys for the moment, we've got 25 in here now, which is pretty good, bearing in mind I haven't uploaded to this channel for a long while yet. But as I say, I'm talking about moving over to this channel for my Saturday live streams, you know. For I'm talking about doing that maybe in the new year, just to keep everything. Because on my Retro Restore channel, the live streams do drop down. My videos get a lot more views than the live stream. So, you know, one thing I need on this channel is more hours watched. I've only got 1,074 hours or something like that. Pete, where hours were before you need to get up to 4,000 to monetize it, obviously. Nick's all right, Mark. How's it going, mate? Hope you and Sharon and the family okay. Yeah, I've still got the remnants of that chest infection thing from when we come back from Cyprus. Sharon's near enough over it now, but it sort of drags on. Then they're not. Someone said, "Oh, you should have the flu jab." No, I don't have the flu jab. The flu jab anyway only vaccinates you against one strain of flu, which they think might be prevalent in the coming year. But there's many different. These are viruses. And there's no medication for a virus, as you probably know. Well, not from the doctor's surgery anyway. So what's this here? What we got here now? Oh, Roads to Blue. Can't chat while watching on TV. No, you can't. That's right. But you watch all the time. Nice one. Yeah. Yeah, that's a point. When you're watching on big screen TV, there is no chat box, is there? What people tend to do is to have their mobile phone as well, or tablet or whatever, and put the same thing on and just watch it on the telly, but just have the chat on their phone or mobile device or whatever. That's the way people get over that. So, but obviously that's just if you've got a mobile device at hand as well, obviously. So MP Dodsworth, good picture here. Yeah, I'm a lot better than what I was, as I say, but it's just at the end sort of thing, you know. What happened to Jimmy's ankle? He fell, Pete. He slipped over, so he told us. And he rolled his ankle. You know, we've all done that before. He walked down a step and his foot went from under him and it swelled up and all that. So that was that. Ian Days. Well, I've not been working. I go on YouTube all day. I can't be bothered with TV. I'll tell you what, that's so true. A lot of people, especially if you're in a community where you talk to people on a live stream, for example, you find the same people. Then they find other live streams of other like-minded people, and you end up with a little community. That's right. It does happen. he says also he's on more medications now and keeps sleeping and missing Chris's shows. I'll put them on at night, Chris's shows, and they send me to sleep because I have trouble sleeping at night because I'm watching too many different videos. So when I do feel a little bit dozy, put on a live stream, any live stream, to be honest with you. I've even put my own on, and they send me to sleep within about 15 minutes. Edward Thomas, I like the lawnmower video yesterday. Yeah, I had some idiot come on, some bloke in there. I left a comment in there. Normally I block idiots. He said, "Oh, you're a lovely chap and all that," he said, "but now you're scraping the bottom of the barrel," he said. "If you want to keep your subscribers, start thinking about more content." What an idiot. That was a valid video about how parts can perish, or if pattern parts, definitely, because I used pattern parts in that 2 years ago, and how it looks after you restore these lawnmowers. I restored that, and it was 2 years ago. 2 years ago in August, just gone. August, September, October. Yeah, and in fact, it's over 2 years ago then. And this idiot made that stupid comment, and I said, don't you, you know, well, look at the comment down there. I think his name was Daniel or something. I can't remember his name now. But I didn't block him. I've just left him a comment back saying it is a valid video at the end of the day. So, yeah, loads of people. Like, you always get one idiot. I'm not going to rant. There's no need to rant today, is there? I'm not on a rant style because I should have ranted yesterday. God, Jesus Christ. With all the things that went wrong yesterday. Hammy Hunter's turned up. Are you Hammy Hunter? Edward Thomas. Yeah. We get, what's this fun things? Get any other internet providers in our area crazy, but you can get fiber from BT only. Yeah, but I've got fiber going to our exchange, but obviously out from into the house is still the old copper cables. You know, I don't suppose they're going to do that. There's no reason. We got a 37, no, guaranteed 35 is what I'll get. I normally get about 33, 34, but I'm down a little bit now, to say 27 yesterday, and I had that bad stream yesterday on mixed mower stream, so that was that. And Alan says, yeah, TV is crap. I've realised that over the last... See, Sharon's in the habit of watching all the soap operas, right? Like Emmerdale, EastEnders, Coronation Street. That's what she does. And I'm in the room, obviously, watching it as well. But 9 times out of 10, they're trying to teach you a lesson or send you a negative message. They're talking about cancer. They're talking about blinking. Oh, everything negative. And even the other day, it went on so much. I said, turn that over. I said, I'm adding up with that. But yeah, YouTube, we watch during the day, obviously, we watch a lot of YouTube. Well, I do anyway. And during the evening, see, Sharon watches different things to me. She watches all these American detective programs and all that. I can't stand all them. No disrespect to the Americans, but it's just I prefer to watch something which I can relate to, sort of thing, you know. And that's just me. Ignore the Muppets like that, mate. Yeah, Trump. I know that, Amy. I know that because I do always, when I get a stupid comment like that, I either block them straight away. Well, I'll leave them a comment back. I answer to them, and then I block them so that they get the comment and they can't come back at me then. And I'll check their channels out normally. And 9 times out of 10, they've got nothing. Absolutely nothing. So, yeah, they are idiots. I know that. We use fun tech. You say you used to have diamond cable when we lived in Lincolnshire. What's that then? What's diamond cable? Am I reading that right? Yeah, it looks like diamond. Yeah, I know. But as I say, even she realises, Sharon, now that it's just a habit forming. Don't forget, habit forming. We've watched them all our lives with our parents and all that. But now, soap operas back then, obviously, in the 70s, 80s, used to mimic working class life, or so they thought. But now, there's an undercurrent of, not evilness, but negativity, where they write these stories to send messages out now, you know, and it's not about working class people anymore. But anyway, that's just an opinion. Does Sharon watch those Desperate Housewives? No, she don't watch them things. No, she likes the what are they called, Gary? Crime scene stuff. Yeah, crime scene and all that stuff she watches. Like, that's sick. Yeah, CSI, that's it, yeah. It's draining watching all the soaps. Yes, I know. And also, they put more than one episode on a night now, on certain nights, don't they? So if you're in your living room at 7 o'clock, for example, you've got 7 to 7:30, which is Emmerdale in the UK. Then from 7:30 to 8:00, you've either got Coronation Street or EastEnders, or Coronation Street. And then at 8:00, EastEnders will come on while Coronation Street's finished. And you watch EastEnders from 8 till 8:30. And then at 8:30 till 9:00, Coronation Street comes on again. So you've got 2 hours from sitting in there in the living room. But it's rubbish, absolute blinking rubbish. But yeah, YouTube's the way to go, I think so anyway. Especially with, like, as I say, these little live streams now, you get a little community going. And as I said to you before, the comment sections, when you go back and look at the video afterwards, if you don't watch it actually live, people are in talking as well and having a right laugh and a bit of banter and all that. And you can actually, so you've got two for the price of one. One, you've got like the interaction between like myself and the comment section. What are you doing, Bryson? Make the blinking noise there. Do you hear that? Come sit down. And then you can go back and have a laugh and a joke in the comment section and see what people are writing. So, yeah, let's have a look here. Diamond Cable was taken over by Virgin Media. I didn't know that. Edward, I'm glad I can read. Probably don't see what these trolls. Yeah, yeah. Well, 9 times out of 10, I'm pretty vigilant on my comments on my videos, and I'll get rid of them. I won't. So I know some people say, "Oh yeah, just ignore them." But you ignore them, and if you leave their comment on there, that 9 times out of 10, other people who like your stuff will go and have a go at the troll, and before you know it, that comment or that troll's comment has got loads and loads of comments where people have had a go at him or disagreed, and he's come back. And before you know it, that becomes what you call a popular comment, and that gets transposed to the top of the comment section. So the first thing people read are the troll, and it gives them a bit of notoriety. So I don't even let that escalate. I'll just get rid of them. Are you Dean? Dean Starks just popped in. Are you, bud? MP Dodsworth. Roy's on Netflix. What do you mean, Roy? Not with you. Nick says, these live streams are more interesting than any TV program. Yeah, yeah. I agree. I never used to watch live streams, to be honest with you. Mitch Mowers and Roy's the Boy started doing live streams. Sharon's brother, Chris, he's been doing live streams for 10 years, you know, and he's got a little niche chat show, which is now starting to pick up now since he's got a few more people. And yeah, you can have a lot of fun. You can have a lot of fun talking to people. Chris French, I put my earphones on and watch YouTube. when the wife is watching all the soaps. Yeah, yeah, it's a good idea, actually. So travel it, yeah, I could probably do with a tablet rather than working off my phone, because I can't read all the small comments now, you know, so. LRH65, hello, Martin, just popped in to say hello. Are you, bud? There's 34 of you in the house now, which ain't too bad. Bearing in mind, I haven't used this channel for ages, and half of the reason is, one, to do a little check, and two, to get some hours up on this channel, because I've only got just over a thousand hours on it. Oh, hello. Hold on. Let's have a go. Is that my phone? Or is it mobile? Oh, it's a mobile, isn't it? Hold on. Who is it? Oh, 0800. Hold on for a minute. Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah, this is Brianna from
BC. Hiya. Yes, she was. Yep. What time would that be? 8 and 1. I'm out. I'll make. Could he make it between 9 and 1?
Yeah, I'll even
update
you. I have no
problem. Brilliant. That's fine. Thank you.
No problem at all.
Bye-bye. BT. They're coming out, not next Tuesday now. They're coming out tomorrow between 9 and 1. That's handy. It's not a big problem, but, I mean, if there is a problem, I'd like it sorted out, because you pay for a service, and I want it sorted. So it's you know, it's slow. It's running slow at the moment. When you're paying for a guaranteed stream of a certain amount of megabytes, I know it's not fantastic, 37 or 35, but I'm only getting 27. Should be better, shouldn't it? Right, what have we got here? Saved by the Bell. Yeah. Alan says, yeah, I agree. There's more soap in the shower than on my TV. No, there's more soap on TV than in my shower. let's have a look here. Right, got rid of these off the boss on phone. Doug's there. Mustache. Okay, Doug's. See you later, buddy. Thanks for popping in anyway. As I say, there's 33 of you in at the moment. I didn't expect to get anybody in, to be honest with you. And it looked that way at the very beginning, because there was only two people, or one person in. What's Gary in the background doing? What are you doing in the background?
Eh?
What are you doing in the background over there?
Yappy sign.
You're watching on there?
Huh?
How did you know yapping?
I've just flicked on, yeah.
He's watching it on the phone over there. Unbelievable. Hammy, yeah, you spent the morning fixing a partner disc cutter you got given for free because it wouldn't start. Quick carb clean and it's good as new. Sold it already, being collected tomorrow. That's the thing, see? Especially these little discs, anything with a small two-stroke engine on, them carbs, it's like anything with lawnmowers. When they've been laid up, people never drain them out. People like, I do it myself. My blinking chainsaw out there, my strimmer out there. You finish using it, put it away, and then you don't use it for maybe months or even over a year. And the first thing to go is the blinking carb jets, the fine jets block up and stuff, and you clean them. That's fine, yeah. Dave says, yeah, I can't stand being brainwashed by the BBC. I think it's all stations, to be honest with you. I don't think it's just the BBC. Not got a television license, they can stick it where the sun don't shine. I know, yeah. It's a very funny thing with a TV license, isn't it? That's the only organisation I know where if you say, let's say, for example, you've insured your car, right? And then you sell your car. You're not going to have a car anymore. You phone your insurance company up. And you say, I want you to insure me car after today, this year. I've sold my car. Put the phone down. That's it. You don't hear from them again because you've sold your car. If you tell them you haven't got a TV anymore, they contact you again and again. And if you don't reply, they'll send someone around. But why? Don't sound right to me. But anyway, that's that. Barry says, I'll get you, Butler. No, I used to get, I hate you, Butler. When I was at school back in the 70s on the buses, I sure I had that on this morning, funny enough. When I wake up sometimes, I put an old blinking comedy on, so it's just nice listening. It was easy listening, easy to watch. You know, that's what I do sometimes. I've done that this morning. MP Dodsworth, where's Tyson? As you probably know, he's normally standing over there, isn't he? Well, he's in the living room because yesterday we had a bit of a photo shoot for Sharon's brother, Chris. That's all I'm going to say. And he was in the photo shoot, let's put it that way, for the calendar we're doing, you know. Jason says, watch Pete C's video. Reuniting the Cortina Swampy last owner. Oh, yeah, I've seen that one, yeah. I watched that video. Yeah, that's a good video, that, isn't it? Yeah. He took the car back, didn't he? We'll have to start calling you Stan. I was never called Stan. I was always, I hate you, Butler, you know. Always, I had that said loads of times when I was a kid. Or get that bus out, Butler. Got to love and leave you, Nick says now. Mark, busy decorating. We'll catch you soon. Take care, mate. Yeah, and take care, Gary. Catch you soon. Cheers. Jason, you and Chris are doing my battery writing today. Why? Why is that? I thought that was funny, what you said on his live stream, karaoke London live stream last Friday. When he, you know, when he buggered up, the Reverend was singing, the Reverend Dave was singing, wasn't he? And he went, well, to the water, and then he's halfway through the song, and the music went off. And Chris, he was accidentally talking to someone, he must have pressed the wrong button. And he had a little bit of a fit, didn't he? And you piped up and said, that's it, DJ Chris is the next one. Going to be hosting it next week. And I didn't realise DJ Chris was actually there, didn't he? He sang a song afterwards. That was quite funny. Well, it's not just, I tell you, for a beginning stream on a channel that I've not used, 30-odd people in the house. Very nice. Thank you very much indeed. As I say, I've only got 13 thumbs up, though. I don't know why that is. You're right, Bison. Look. Andy, every time I live stream, he comes here for some reason. Look. Don't you? Right? He's a good boy. Don't you? Hey? Look at him. Look. They say they're violent, they Rottweilers. He's soft as anything, isn't he, mate? He's a protector. Don't you? Good boy. Yes, it is all about the banter, Jason. You're right. And that's what you get, as I say, in the comment section. You do get a bit of banter in there, and it's funny to read back sometimes, and I've said it many a time, funny to read back, and you can I've actually chuckled out loud when I've done that, or laughed out loud. I see Chris got a few super chats this morning, didn't he? Oh, hello. That might be Sharon coming in. Or could, what's the time? Yeah, could be Sharon coming in. She's been up Gary's all morning, hasn't she, Gary?
Yeah, nice, Jimmy.
Oh, it's Jimmy, is it? Oh, he's been driving around to charge the battery up. You need petrol? Come shout out to everybody. You got what? Got to brush your teeth quickly. What's that all about? yeah. Pee Wee 15's in the room. Who else we got there? Did you see Mixed Mail's Halloween video with the coffin? I mentioned the Muppet in the coffin on his live stream on Sunday. Yeah, I did see that, actually. Yeah, he frightened the life out of some little kids. I know. It looked quite good, didn't it? Yeah. He does do that. He gets all dressed up with all that, doesn't he, Mick? He loves all that. No, it was good. Are you Ken? Ken Broadwell, any die-cast cars? Well, I'm starting, hopefully, Ken, to maybe... I've got things to finish off. We're right on top of Christmas now, but I want to start going again with the die-cast cars. Hold on. This is one I had, which I want to get going as well. Oh, I'm putting it to the microphone for some reason. Was that old Rover? You remember the old Rover P6s? That's one. The glass is broken in it, though, at the back there, as you can probably see. Look. So you can get parts for some of these little things. I'm hoping to get new glass. The trouble is the seller I found on YouTube, not YouTube, sorry, on eBay, he charges only about £3.50 for the part or £4.99, something like that. Well, I ain't got a problem with that, but he charges £3.50 to send them, and that's a bit steep, you know? So I don't know whether there's another way to find someone else doing them or whether you can get from any other supplier. He must be getting them from somewhere. I don't think he's manufacturing them. I'm not sure. So I really don't know. But that was that. And where's that coach of mine? Hold on. That coach, as you know, I restored on the Retro Hacks channel. And that's turned out really nice. That has. I don't know if you see. No, you can't see the finish on it, really, can you? Again, that's powder coated, you know, and that's really hard wearing. After it dries, you ain't going to chip that off. And that's really, really solid on there. And as someone pointed out, they did these coaches in a few different types. I got this out of a box on an auto jumble, and there was about five or six of these ones, all in different states of repair. And when I turned them upside down, some of them had the little trap doors on there where you can put batteries in. And I found this one, which didn't have trap door in, because apparently they have lights on the side there, little indicator lights that can turn on and off or flash on and off when you lean it over. Because when you lean this over, the wheels turn and you can actually steer it by leaning it. So that's a good thing. But no, I went for the one without the trap door. So obviously it had the holes there. It was the same casting. But these new stickers that I put on, as you can see, you can just see the little dimple there underneath where the old... I didn't want to fill it in case anyone ever wanted to fill it in. Anyone wanted to restore... Well, I've restored it anyway. But you can see the seats inside underneath there were blue. You can just see in there, look. And I thought they looked better in maroon, so I actually done them in maroon. I think it does look a lot better in maroon, to be honest with you. But I cleaned the glass up. I didn't really polish it, but it's good enough. It was a lot more scratched than that. And I also painted that grille in silver at the front there. That wasn't painted silver. And I had to put new jewels in there, little jewel things there, because I tried pulling them out, but they all broke. So I ended up sandblasting them, and they all just disintegrated. And as I said before, I just painted them little details in there. So, yeah, that was that. But that turned out lovely. And even underneath sort of thing, you know, that's the powder coat. That's the quality of the powder coating. It's really hard wearing and all, you know. But I wouldn't really powder coat. I did powder coat a smaller car, as you know, as a test. And one this sort of size. In fact, no, it's actually smaller than that. And you can lose a bit of the detail. But on something this sort of size, it don't really matter. But, yeah, I want to do some more. Detailed powder coat, not powder coating, do some more restorations with them. I used to enjoy doing them. What else we got there? Looks like a Dodge. No, I don't know. What is it? I can't think what it was again. It was a Vega Major luxury coach. It don't actually tell you what make it is. Meccano Limited, made in England by Dinky. Dinky Super Toy. That's what that is. Yeah, nice though. And I think they're going for about £10, £8 to £10 on eBay. But in this condition, especially if I had a box, because you can buy pattern boxes now and put that in there. Again, they're display pieces. They're never gonna this sort of thing is never gonna be used again by any kids, although I've got grandchildren. But once you've done this amount of work to them, it's more of a display piece, like for a man cave or whatever, you know. Oh, nice. We've got 40 people in here now. Yeah, was it Ken? Was it you, Ken, who asked that question? I can't remember. Let's just scroll down. Pompey Dan, how are you, buddy? 1974. Mike Hunt, good afternoon, Mike. Let's have a look. Yeah, you watched it. Yeah, it does look lovely. But again, that's why I don't know whether to do a dedicated channel for these, because a lot of the people on my Retro Restore channel, I've got a special... I can't... See, variety channels don't tend to do too well. If you do many things... although a lot of people who do watch and who are subscribers like what you do, YouTube tends to, if they see you doing loads of different things, you don't get sort of recommended very often. You've got to specialize. So I may just do these on one channel, and whether it's this channel or I don't know, I'm not sure yet. I've got the Butler's Empire channel, as you know. I've got a couple of other channels, the old t-shirt channel, which Sharon started doing some kids videos for the grandchildren and that. But again, it's time constraints, really. But, and again, I've got all 30,000 plus subscribers on the t-shirt training video channel, which I used to do videos on for the last sort of 10 years or whatever. But they're not the same market as whatever I do decide to go into next. So I may decide not to, even though that site's monetized and even that's earning money now. Even though I've not uploaded on that since January, but you get a lot of negative when you start putting new content on a different channel of a different type. People start saying, "Oh, what's all this rubbish and all that?" Blah, blah, blah. So that's why we stopped uploading to that for that reason as well. So I don't know, not too sure yet. Barstow at the Vegas. I thought variety also spice of life. Exactly. I mean, I can't do just one thing. I like to do various things. You know. I get very bored. I couldn't just do one thing for the and say that's what I'm going to do for the rest of my life. I couldn't do that. You know, I've done that for 25 years when I was an electrician. So, and I like doing different things. And having this sort of channel, like a restoration channel, I can restore different things, sort of thing. You know, and I like that. But that car restoration, things like that, the Corgi car is a niche within itself, sort of thing. You know, and I do watch a few of them. There's a bloke called Max Box. Marty's Matchbox Makeover to something. He's in America. No, he's not. He's in Australia. He was a British chap, but he's in Australia now. And he's got over just touched the 100,000 subscribers. Who's that, baby? Is that you, Sharon? Yeah. Say hello. We're on Butler's Empire, baby.
Who are you talking to?
Everybody.
Well, you got Joplin's daughter in law.
What's that?
She's going to plug this in. She's brought it brand new, but she's had it too long.
All right.
And I said, I know a man that can.
44 people in the house, Sharon, on Butler's Empire. That's not bad, is it?
Look.
What's that?
It's arrived. Oh. Well, she's only opened the box now.
That's one of the only troubles with buying things through the post. Not look at that, look. I know it's only a plug, but...
Just put it in there.
If that was a pensioner, they might try and plug that in.
Mum, try it.
Mum, try it, he just said. Oh, right, take it away, baby.
That's a little job for you.
What's that for, Sharon?
Oh,
God, you've fricked the life out of me.
We're breaking, it's nice,
we've broken already, Sharon.
Well, what do you think it's for, love?
Easter. Look, it's one of the things they're not... Bryson, look, what's she up to, Sharon?
I've got to
touch. What for?
Post office is sharp. Have you been down the village?
Happy days. Ian Day says hello, Sharon, and also Jason says hello.
It's pouring here.
Ken says, Aussie guy, yeah, he's good to watch as a free... As a 3D print, has he got a 3D print? I didn't know
we're
that.
Good to watch. Oh, look at my
hair. Yeah, we got 41. Oh, Shell. I just said.
It's shocking, isn't it?
Unbelievable, Shell. We haven't used this channel for ages. We've got 42 people in.
Don't forget, share, subscribe, and like.
No, like I said, it's just a test on this one, Shell.
Well, no, it's still needed, do it?
Comb your hair, baby. Look looks like you've come here on a motorbike.
Feels like.
Olive. And the bus. I hate you, Butler. Someone just said, I hate you, Butler, on there, Shell. I nearly pulled Snowman's head off, Pete. Oh, good job, Sharon wasn't a burglar.
I know my dogs. Yeah,
she knows the dogs. Don't worry about that.
So I'm going to touch your letters.
Nick says, "Afternoon, Martin. How's about a comparison between powder coating a Tonka truck and the one you previously painted?" I've done that already. I think. Wait there. Shout.
Oh. Absolutely flooded. I had to go up the road to cross over to go to the post office.
Done that already? I've done that. Look, kids do play with these. Look. This was the one that I painted, as you said. And as you can see, it's all battered and chipped and all that. Look where they sit in there and they've actually bent that outwards. I think it's been bent back again now, where they sit in it. And that was the painted one, as you can see. Battered but used. I think that's the way Tonka toys are supposed to be. I made them stickers up, as you remember, with the what they call the water slide transfers. But you can buy them, apparently. But I've got the computer. I've got the printer. I've got a little bit of software.
You've got it all, haven't you?
So that was that one. So that's how the paint is fared after really being play-worn in that short amount of time. So that's painted and lacquered with 2K car lacquer. This one. Where is it? This one. Again, same play-worn, but this time it's powder-coated. And there's no chips on this one whatsoever. You can't see it really clear, can you? No, you can't really see it, can you? That's not chipped or nothing. Look.
You've got matte tea, Gary.
And that's the difference between powder coating. It's a wonder why they didn't powder coat in the 70s or whatever when they actually produced them. So this one's got literally no chips on it whatsoever. And this has been played the same way, believe me. Yeah, look. Powder coating is so much more durable, as you can see there, look. So that's the difference between powder coating and painting. Let's get him over there. Push him over there. Yeah, so that's that. Let's have a look here. What about restoring a petrol can? I've had loads, but no idea where to start. Well, see, this is the thing. With the petrol cans, it depends whether you want to make them original looking or get them back to perfect A1 condition. I don't see the point in that, in doing A1 condition, because a lot of times they're pitted, you know, and that pittedness is part of its charm in my way of thinking. So I will powder coat or paint or whatever. And I don't really want it to have to look brand spanking new sort of thing, you know.
You like the patina.
I like the patina, yeah. Patina. Even though it's repainted, or I want to see how it used to be with the graphics on, you know, like old Esso on it, or Shell, or Duckham's, or Esso Blue.
I still think
I'm not doing. I'm not doing one with that on Shell. I'm not doing one with that on. So yeah, I've done one petrol can. I've got another one sitting outside, funny enough. So I will do that as well. Jess White, hiya, buddy. Or is it her? I'm not sure. Yeah, Ken says make the plastic accessory stuff. Well, that's another reason why I got that 3D printer for, to make. Sometimes these parts come and they've got bits missing, and you can make them apparently. So I've been watching a few videos and it's looking okay. Dear Father Christmas, I want another Tonka truck. Oh, yeah, I shouldn't leave him there, shall. Jimmy fell over, didn't he? So we don't want him tripping over. You tripping over, baby, didn't you? You won't be able to make me.
He left them there like that.
You won't be able to make me a cup of tea, will you?
Well, I'm going out in a second.
Eh?
Just told you I'm going to Tattershall.
What for, baby?
Post Gary's letter off.
Well, can't Gary post it?
Well, no, because I'm everything to go. I have to do everything for that boy. He can't cope without his mother.
Calls him with a job.
Did you come to work on a motorbike? Shaz is feeling the cold. She's only just walked in, yeah. I've only just let her back in the house.
I'll go back out now, lad. Check sign, then I'm out.
More tea, Vicar. What are you saying there, Ian? I've still got my Tonka truck. I never had one as a kid. I always wanted one, but never. Bison, can you go and sit down, please? I don't know if you can see this, but when these lights are on above my head. Bison, get back.
Beautiful dog.
My watch puts a reflection on that filing cabinet there, and he chases it. That's why he's always here. Right, well, as I say, I've got work to do, folks, so thanks very much for popping on this little stream.
That means he's coming to Tattershall.
Thanks for coming on to the little stream for us, and Sharon, say thank you, baby.
Thank you, baby.
Gary?
Bye.
Oh, you see his hand there, look, just in the corner. Yeah, so as I say, this wasn't a proper... It was just a little chat, actually. How long have we been running on here, Sharon? I can't see the time. Oh, three quarters of an hour. Bloody, the time fly when you're having fun.
Go on. Jesus Christ.
Are you, Jack? We're just actually going, Jack. You just popped in to say hello, hopefully. I don't think, yeah, Edward says he's got a Tonka truck better than these plastic toys you get nowadays.
They last longer.
Well, look at them, Sharon. Mm. Look at them. Trouble is now, they would probably not be safe because they're metal.
Well, what about, you can't buy a poppy now and you can't get the pin because it's health and safety.
Listen to this.
Jimmy got his poppy the other day. He says, Mum, can go in your room. He's got a little sewing room. I love my sewing room. I need a pin because you can't get them with your poppies because of health and safety.
Don't know. Jason says, Martin,
there's no super chat sign there, is
when it? I try, no, not on this. He said, when I try to send a super chat, it's locked on 199 and I'm unable to change it. Any ideas? No, I don't know, Jason.
Oh, Chris said he had that the other day.
Did he?
Or was it just you? Or did you say that on Chris's show the other day?
I don't recall it. Yeah. He had a few super chats this morning, Sharon, your brother.
He said he was hungry, didn't he? Paid his electric.
Yeah, well, they can't super chat us on there. Look, we've got no monetization. Look. That's why I'm hoping that we can get some more hours up on this. Yeah, see you later, Grandad. TTFN to half an hour. MP Dodger, if you cannot clap your hand, you cannot clap your hands, Martin. What do you mean, bud? I can clap my hands. Are you talking about that? Have we done that on the video? Oh, I don't know. Anyway, ciao. We're going to say ta-da. We just literally popped on to do a little test stream.
No, you did.
It seems to work on it. As I say, it's me. What's that? Sorry. No, it wasn't me. I had to send Chris 199 five times. I just showed him the format of the calendar, ciao. I didn't show him the calendar. I showed him that's the format it's going to be in. These ain't going to be. I told him that's not going to be the pictures. But just to see January, February, that sort of format. It's a nice little thing, isn't it?
A4.
And, that was the test one. The actual pictures are here. I can't show you them.
You don't want to see them.
No, you don't want to see them. Not yet, anyway. It'll spoil.
Scroll your surprise when you open that envelope and see them pictures.
Mike Gunst, Sharon, says, have a good evening. Don't watch the soaps.
I do watch the soap.
Exactly.
But my favourite at the moment is Strictly on a Saturday.
All right, shout. We've got to go. You're boring me.
How rude.
I'll see you later, folks. We're going to end the stream now. Thanks very much for popping in. We had up to about 45 people in, which is fantastic, on a test stream. See you again. And don't forget, Retro Restore during the week. What's today? Thursday. No, Saturday. Join us on Saturday's live stream, 2 o'clock, British UK time, on Retro Restore. See you later, folks.
Give the money for the
phone.